Edmund, you've shown true courage today, and luck was on your side. I take it you've taken the leaders of the opposition as prisoners. I need to take custody of them so I can do what's best for our concern for their honor and the safety of our kingdom.
Sir, I decided it was appropriate to send the pathetic old king to a guarded prison cell. His old age and title make him so popular among the commoners that I was worried our enlisted soldiers would turn against us on his behalf. I sent Cordelia with him too, for the same reason. They're ready to meet up with you tomorrow, or whenever you'd like, wherever you'd like to hold your hearing. These are difficult times. Many have lost friends in battle, and soldiers will curse even a justified war if it causes them pain. We need a more appropriate place to discuss Cordelia and her father.
By your patience, I hold you but a subject of this war, not as a brother.
This is my decision! Should have asked my opinion on the matter. Edmund has led our forces and implemented my wishes. His close connection to me gives him the right to be considered your equal. By me invested, he compares the best.
That were the most if he should husband you.
Jesters do off-proof prophets. General, take my soldiers, my prisoners, my whole inheritance, and do as you like with them. I surrender myself to your good judgment. Let the whole world see that I hereby make you my lord and master.
Edmund, you're under arrest for capital treason. My dear sister-in-law, I veto your marriage announcement for the benefit of my wife, who is already engaged to Edmund. So if you want to get married, you'll have to woo me. You've got a sword, Gloucester. Blow your trumpet. If nobody else comes to challenge you and prove what an abominable traitor you are, I'll have to challenge you myself. I'll prove soon enough that you're just as wicked as I say you are.
Sick! Oh, sick!
You're on. Whoever calls me a traitor is a vicious liar. I'll blow the trumpet. Anyone who dares step forward and make that accusation, you or anyone else, go ahead.
I feel worse.
You're not well. Go to my tent. Who are you? What is your name and rank, and why are you stepping forward?
I've lost my name and title to a traitor, but I'm as noble as my opponent.
And who's that?
Who is the spokesman for Edmund, Earl of Gloucester?
Himself? What sayest thou to him?
Draw your sword. If I offend you by what I say, you can use your sword to take revenge. Here's mine. Look at it. It's a symbol of my honor, my rank, and my status as a knight. In spite of your youth, rank, strength, and excellence at warfare, in spite of your courage, your recent victory, and your good luck, I declare that you're a traitor. You've betrayed your gods, your brother, and your father. You plotted against this noble duke. You're a rotten traitor, from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. If you disagree with me, I'm ready to use this sword and my courage to prove that you're a liar.
Normally I would ask you what your name is, but since you look so fine and noble, I'm prepared to overlook the rules of knighthood. Which say, I should refuse to fight a man I don't know. Throw your accusations back in your face. Your lies can hardly hurt me, but I'll still fight you and embed your lies back into your hellish heart. Cue the sweet fight scene song!
Do you know what letter this is?
Ask me not what I know. I've done everything you accuse me of.
and more, much more. You'll find out everything in due time. It's all over now, and so am I. But who are you? You who've managed to defeat me?
Let's forgive each other. I'm no less noble than you are, Edmund. If I'm more noble than you, you've done me wrong. My name is Edgar, and I'm your father's son. The gods are fair, and they use our little vices to punish us. The woman he committed adultery with, your mother, cost him his eyes.
You're right. That's true. It's all come full circle, and here I am.
I suspected that you were a noble when I saw how you walked. Let me embrace you. I swear I've never hated you or your father.
Worthy prince, I know.
Where have you been hiding? How did you know what happened to your poor father?
I knew because I helped nurse him through his suffering. Listen to my little story, and when it's done, oh, my heart will break. To escape the decree condemning me to death, I disguised myself as a madman beggar and became a creature despised even by dogs. Oh, how sweet our lives must be if we prefer to die gradually by debasing ourselves rather than dying all at once. In that disguise, I met up with my father with bloody sockets where his beautiful eyes used to be. I became his guide. I led him and begged for him and kept him from suicide. I never revealed myself to him until half an hour ago when I was in my armor. With hope in my heart, I asked him for his blessing, not sure that he'd give it to me. He did. I told him everything that happened on my journey, but his frail heart, too weak to grapple with such a conflict between joy and sadness, gave out.
Your words have hurt me, and maybe it'll do some good. But go on, you look like you have something more to say.
If there's anything more sorrowful left to add, keep it to yourself. I'm almost ready to break down hearing this much.
This may have seemed like the pinnacle of sadness, but if I went on, I could outdo it. While I was sobbing loudly, a man came in. He had seen me in my ragged clothes and shunned me, but when he found out who I was, he clasped my neck with his strong arms and cried to high heaven. He threw himself on my father and told the saddest story you've ever heard about Lear and him. As he was telling the story, he grieved more and more until his heart started to break. Then I heard the trumpets blow twice and left him there in a trance.
But who was that man?
It was Kent, sir, the exiled Kent, who, after the king treated him like an enemy of the state, put on a disguise and followed his king, carrying out tasks unworthy of even a slave.
Help! Help!
What kind of help?
Say something, man.
What is that bloody knife?
It's still warped from the cut. It was just removed from the heart of... Oh, she's dead.
Who's dead?
Your wife, sir. Her sister's dead too, poisoned by your wife. She confessed.
I was engaged to both of them, and now we are wedded to death?
Here comes Kent.
I've come to say farewell to my king and master.
Is he not here?
What a thing to forget. Edmund, tell us, where is the king? Where is Cordelia?
I wish I could live longer, and do a little despite my evil natures. Go quickly, hurry, to the castle. For I've given orders to Lear and Cordelia killed. Hurry, send someone immediately.
Run! Run!
We should send something to prove you're withdrawing orders.
Good idea. Take my sword. The captain. Give it to the captain. My wife and I ordered him to hang Cordelia in prison, and then make it look as if she committed suicide in despair. Bleh.
Heaven help them.
Howl, 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 howl. Oh, you men are made of stone. If I were you with eyes and a tongue to speak with, I'd crack heaven wide open with my laments. She's gone forever. I know how to tell when someone is alive or dead. She's as dead as the cold ground. Let me borrow a mirror. If her breath steams up the glass, then she's alive.
Is this the promised end?
Or just a prelude to it?
This feather moves because of her breath. She's alive. If that's true, it makes up for all the sorrows I've ever known.
Oh, my good master.
Please go away.
It's noble Kent, your friend.
Curse you all. You're all murderers and traitors. I could have saved her. Now she's gone forever. Cordelia, Cordelia, stay a while. Huh? What are you saying? Her voice always was so soft and gentle. That's a good thing in a woman. I killed the scum who was hanging you. Who are you? my eyesight is not the best.
It's me, your servant Kent. Where's your servant Kais?
He's a good fellow. I can tell you that much. Not afraid to fight. He's a feisty one. He's dead and rotting in the dirt now.
No, my lord. It was me. I'm the one who followed you on your sad wanderings.
Nice to see you.
It was me. No one else. Everything is gloomy, dark, and dreadful. Your eldest daughters destroyed themselves and died in despair.
Yes, I think that's true.
He doesn't know what he's saying. It's useless to try to talk to him. I'll do everything I can to ease the king's suffering. As for me, I'm surrendering all my power over him, giving him absolute authority to the rest of his life. You will get back your rightful property and titles along with new honors that you have more than deserved. My friends and allies will be rewarded for their support, and my enemies will get what they deserve.
My poor fool was hanged. No, no, no life left. Why should a dog or a horse or rat have life, but not you? You'll never come to me again. Never, never, never. Please help me undo this button. Thank you, sir. Do you see that? Look at her. Look, her lips. Look there. Look there. Oh. Blood.
My lord, my lord.
My heart breaks.
Look at me, my lord.
Don't disturb his soul. Let it go up to heaven. His soul will be angry at anyone who tried to keep him in the torture chamber of his life.
He really is gone.
It's amazing how long he lasted. He was living on borrowed time at the end.
Our business now is mourning and grief. My friends and soulmates, you too will reign over this kingdom and keep the wounded country alive.
I will have to go on a journey to death soon, sir. My master's calling me. I can't say no.
We must remember the gravity of this sad day. We should speak what we feel, not what we ought to say. The oldest one suffered the most. We young ones will never see as much as he has seen, or live as long.
Mine diamonds! Mine...